Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here. In my first video on Dapper, I showed how to use the state store. In this video, I will show how to switch from the default Redis state store to MySQL. Let's go.
Good morning, everyone. No, let's try that again. Good morning, everyone. Oh, perfect.
Check the description for a link to the intro video and watch it first because we're gonna pick up right where we left off. Start a MySQL server with Docker. With MySQL running, make a copy of the Redis state store component and name it mysqlstatestore.yaml. First, change the name, which is how Dapper addresses a component. Next, change the type from Redis to MySQL. The MySQL component requires a connection string. Notice the connection string did not include a schema. The schema and table will be created automatically. However, additional metadata can be provided to override the default values. Finally, remove the Redis password and save the file. With our component defined, we can run Dapper. This instance will have an app ID of MySQL test and run on port 3500. I will use the REST client extension for Visual Studio Code to send HTTP requests to Dapper. So I create an HTTP file to save the request. To confirm that everything is configured correctly, start the Dapper dashboard. While Dapper and the dashboard start, create the request. To save state, use a POST request with a JSON body. The address is localhost on port 3500, v1.0, state, and the name of the state store, which is MySQL state store. The JSON body is an array of key value pairs. To retrieve state, use a GET request to the same address with the key added at the end. In this example, the key is dog. Opening the Dapper dashboard confirms our app is registered. The dashboard also lists the components. The first component is our new MySQL state store. Notice the default Redis state store is still available. With confirmation that everything is configured correctly, Dapper is ready to receive request. First, issue a POST request to save state. The response is a 204, indicating that the state was saved. Finally, issue a GET request to retrieve the state, and the value hybrid is returned. Swapping components in Dapper is as easy as adding new YAML files. Check the Dapper docs for a list of supported components and configuration details. To learn more, visit dapper.io and join the Dapper community on Discord.
Good morning, everyone. No, let's try that again. Good morning, everyone. Oh, perfect.